pretty good. He usually smells lard. Here comes the World Television Champion. The new World Television Champion, Scott Steiner of the NWO, along with Buff Bagwell, in a title defense here on WCW Monday Night Raw. Yes, for those of you who been with us all night, Eric Bischoff is still in our broadcast location, although he has refused to talk. Eric, you're still a part of this broadcast team. You are still welcome. No, no, you're expected to add commentary.
Didn't Flair put you in charge of?
Well, yes, and then
Eric?
Yes, he did. And I'm only in a supervisory capacity, which means I report to Flair, which means tomorrow, and I've told you this, Eric, full report on Mr. Flair's desk.
When you were a kid in school, did you tell on other kids?
No.
I did.
Well, I bet
you
did.
Oh, fun.
Cut the music! As all you women are tripping, looking at the greatest body in professional sports, I need to know one thing. If you're tired of being with your fat, out of shape, gas pumping redneck, and you want to be with a real man, 'cause all you got to do is grab my hand, and I'll take you to Loveland, and I'll show you who's the Superman. So this goes to all you freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
A lot of freaks out there.
You know, ever since me and Buff burned Mark McGuire's hat and jersey, WCW have tried to censor me.
Please.
You see, every attack that I've done on WCW have been for a reason. And now that I got the belt, you can't censor me. I'm out of control. I'm out of my mind, and I'm loving it.
Scotty, listen. Let me show you something I learned. You're gonna love it. Watch this.
Whoa, you okay, Marcus? Marcus, what's the matter? Come on.
I just got over that triple bypass surgery. I shouldn't be doing this dance yet.
Don't do that dance then, man. Now, for some reason, K-Dog wants me to beat him up one more time, so I don't have a problem with that. So, K-Dog, come back down here right now so I can beat you up, and then I'm coming out after one of you people that thinks they're man enough to make me take me out.
So here comes the former television champion, Conan.
Come on, rednecks! You are next! After I beat him, I'm coming out in the crowd!
Big Papa Pop of the NWO, of your NWO, Bischoff, is a man truly, literally, out of control.
Well, this man Conan is a street person. He can do aerial moves, he can wrestle in the ring, he can fight you outside, he can do whatever you want to do. I don't think I'd call this man up. Would you, Mike? I mean, Eric? He's doing his Marcel impersonation.
Been doing it all night.
Why don't you have him sit on your lap and put your hand up his back like a puppet?
Could you shut up?
Sorry, Howdy.
Yo, K-Dog! What, you didn't have enough last week? You want to get your butt kicked again, boy? Because I'll do it. You got that?
Match gets jump started as K-Dog takes up both men. And Conan, right hands. The whip into the ropes. Oh, and a clubbing forearm shot between the shoulder blades by Big Papa Pump. Into the ropes, ducking low, watch out. To the midsection, it's staggered, Big Papa Pop. Throw him down, head first. K-Dog could regain the belt right here. Now he walked away, he's going for the tequila sunrise.
Oh yeah, Jimmy Buffett, I hear it.
That was, Actually, the Eagles sang that song. Watch out! Knocked him down.
Close.
And the bell is sounded in the grips of the Tequila Sunrise. Buff Bagwell enables Big Papa Pump to hold onto the belt, and he shoved the referee. And now their bozo referee comes in. And they're gonna put on the Steiner recliner for what? Match is over. Well, the referee's calling for the bell.
Who's your winner on this one?
Well, K-Dog is your winner. Conan's your winner by disqualification. But Brain, as you know, he won't win the belt this way. The belt will stay around the waist of Scott Steiner. Uh-oh.
He's not coming here, is he?
I pray not. If he comes here, Bischoff, we're getting behind you.
And I'll be behind you, Tony. They're doing a number of Conan right now.
Oh, boy, they're just trying to destroy Conan. First of all, on the shoulder, now on the knee with that steel chair.
There he is, Big Papa Pump.
And I hate to even say this, but you can look and you can see. That man is a powerful athlete. That man is really a champion.
Two good-looking people.
What do they have?
Amazing.
Tonight, the NWO gets stronger than it ever will be, because tonight, the man with the greatest body in professional sports takes on WCW's so-called People's Champion. Now, Tony Schiavone.
What?
If you call Diamond Dallas Page the People's Champion one more time, I'm gonna puke. Because Diamond Dallas Page, I look at you and I see white trash. I look out in the crowd, I see white trash. So maybe you are the People's Champion. Get out and shut up. Diamond Dallas Page, you have nothing I want. You have nothing I need. But you got somebody that wants me. And after I beat you tonight, I'm gonna take your wife and I'm gonna show her what it's like to be with a real man.
You're stepping over the line here, I believe. But that's their way.
Look at that, Diamond Dallas Page. My arm is bigger than your leg.
The Hells Angels. How will it escalate? Where will it continue? Will it end? Those are the stories that we follow each and every Monday on Nitro, each and every Thursday on Thunder, on Saturday night, and of course, with the unexpected event that you never know what's going to happen next, that's called Sold Out this coming Sunday.
You know what I'm saying?
Scott Steiner throw up here?
Please.
Should I call Diamond Dallas Page the People's Champion again?
Again.
The People's Champion.
How about one more time for the pumper?
All right, my apologies to Big Papa Forrest Gump, but it is the People's Champion, Diamond Dallas Page. And he'll be coming out here as Scott Steiner and Buff Bagwell. No denying Scott Steiner's ability. Look at the man. He is a magnificent athlete. And he truly is the television champ. But as he poses and shows his wares in the ring, we saw just a moment over there in the corner that, as you look at our fans here at ringside, Charles Robinson is the referee. Not a good place to be with Scott. What is he doing?
She knows what a man is.
Enough of that. All right, this is going to be a great one, guys. Diamond Dallas Page has always done, I feel, what is right. Steiner. Hey, Steiner going out.
Could be the break Diamond was looking for. Just one opening's all you need sometimes.
A pickup atomic drop. Page, another discus clothesline that time. Has him hooked. Could be, yes! Hit him. And that means there could be a diamond cutter.
Wait a minute.
Oh, Vincent had come in and grabbed the referee. The referee hit by Page. Page gets hit with powder in the eye.
By Bagwell from ringside. Diamond cutter on Vincent.
Punk pushed him in.
That's exactly what he did. Vincent gets wiped out. Page did not realize. Who he hit with a diamond cutter. But he knows what's going on now. He just got whacked with a chair. So now.
Uh-oh. Gonna sit back with that Steiner recliner.
And here the referee is back into it.
He used a chair.
Page is unconscious.
Yeah, that's exactly what I said. There's no way he's gonna give up. The only way would be to knock him out. And that's exactly what they did. Scott Steiner wins. Holds on to the TV belt as he whacks out DDP with a chair. Vincent gets the brunt of a diamond cutter. As Big Papa Pump put,
baby.
But I tell you, it was another great matchup.
The gallant effort by DDP.
I'm not even getting freaked out, man.
You know what?
DDP
just got bashed.
Oh, shut up. Get the cameras off these fools.
Hey, they'll play that package with Nash. And the gorgeous Nitro girls are here, and they're going to be in San Antonio when tickets go on sale this Friday, January 22nd. At the Alamo Dome for our next big event, which will be Friday, February 26th. The Nitro girls are out, and they are gorgeous. There's Kimberly in the center. Whisper over on the left there. And they are certainly a big part of Monday Nitro. AC Jazz and Melissa. What? Also known as Spice. She is up on top.
Whoa. Cut the music. I want you girls to stop dancing because Big Papa Pump is looking for a little romancing. Now, how about you, baby? You want to know what it's like to touch a real man?
That's Jay. Huh? He needs to leave her alone.
You want to be a real man? How about you? You want to be with a real man? I seen your man, and I beat your man like a dog.
You better get
out of
here.
Girls.
I'm sorry.
Take a look at a real man.
We apologize.
Hi, where you going?
There goes fire.
Come on, baby. You want some?
She needs to walk away
you
as
want
well.
Some? Come on. Be with a freak. Come on.
We'll be back.
Where y'all going?
This is hideous.
I know there's some freaks out there in Columbus, Ohio. They have never been with a man like me. So after the show, Big Papa Pump is ready to go.
Bagwell or Big Papa Pump or anybody from the NWO coming out and accosting them like what just went down.
It's just nonsense. I mean, since the start of professional wrestling, intimidation has been a big part. I mean, it always has been, it always will be, but we're talking about in the ring. I mean, what's the point of seeing Scott Steiner, Big Papa Pump, come out here and he beats up mascots like Wildcat Willie? He tries to intimidate the Nitro girls. There's no part for that.
Usually, you know why a bully's a bully, don't you, Mike?
Probably can be.
Because they can be, and that's what he wants, his attention. It's all Big Papa Pump wants. He wants to go out there, get attention at somebody else's expense. And if it works, it works.
And then, of course, sometimes a bully is a bully until someone hits him in the mouth. But, of course, if you hit somebody in the NWO in the mouth, you got to contend with the whole group. Boy, Bubba Bagwell's come a long way, hasn't he? He's looking good.
Sure the family's proud.
Oh, what a story.
He's lucky he's walking.
As all you scumbags from the state of Ohio have heard, Big Papa Pump is looking for a freak of the week. I'm looking for a hooch that I can grip her hips and move. And I'm talking about all
all night long. So this goes to all you freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me. Now that's me and Buff. We're in the back. We seen somebody that was dressed in a dress that had some ugly tattoos, ugly legs, ugly face.
Tony, your wife's here.
He definitely doesn't look as good as I do. So Perry Saturn, come on down here with that dress, and I'll show you what it's like to wrestle against a real man.
Saturn's a real man, no doubt about it.
And he's got to wear the dress, and Big Papa Pop is calling Saturn out. It's not going to be a pretty sight. It's going to be a very embarrassing moment for Perry Saturn.
Perry Saturn has never been one to back down from a challenge. We saw that recently when Chris Jericho, oh no. Well, that's the stipulation that he agreed to. Now he's got to pay it off. Jericho demanded, Jericho challenged him for that dress match. Perry Saturn accepted that. Now he's here to fight Scott Steiner.
But you know, with a nice pearl choke,
that's
it may not look
bad. That's almost as ridiculous as this hat. Look at that. He's like Mr. Man.
That's not funny, great.
Little corsage there. Lose the tape. And a hat maybe with a flower on it. Nah. That's still Saturn, even in a dress. One tough man.
Now, Perry Saturn, I've always said there's two things from Texas, steers and queers. Now, I know you're not from Texas, and I don't see no horns, so you must be a little.
Whoa. Send him to the desert. You're headed for Death Valley.
Scott Steiner pulled the legs, or Buff pulled the legs of Scott Steiner. Can that stop that DVD attempt?
Oh. Oh. Overhead release suplex by Scott Steiner.
Steiner recliner, he's going for it.
Devastating finishing move.
Look at the chest, look at the arms, look at the traps on that man. Stronger than a gorilla.
Is that two? That's three.
Yeah, he's gone.
He's passed out.
He's gone out. You're right. He didn't give up.
He couldn't.
He didn't tap out. He passed out is what he did.
He's unconscious.
So Big Papa Pump puts on the Steiner recliner until Perry Saturn goes out and gets a win on Monday Nitro. Well, we're not finished, unfortunately, with the Wolfpack yet.
Who's the man? Ah! Hey, look at that arm!
Lex
That's
Luger's
not
still
the
to
man.
Come against Ray Jr.
That is the largest arm in the world
and
today.
And more live on TNT from Columbus, Ohio.
No, you shut!
Greatest view in wrestling. You gotta slow down. You've got a great body.
Can't follow me.
I've got a great body. Me and you've gotta be together.
Whoa.
Wait a second, Scotty.
Doing
She wants me. These girls want me. No, I'll pick her first, and they're all mad.
No, we're mad because you're in here and we want you to get out.
I beat her husband. You guys see me beat her husband last week.
That's got nothing to do with the women's locker room, though, Scotty.
They're just mad because they're not with me. Kimberly, I'll be back. You girls are next, okay? But she's first. Wait, hang on.
Huh? Oh, this guy's delusional.
She asked me in there. You know I'm
a burger.
No, we need to talk. Seriously, we need to talk. Your old man's in Vegas. We're gonna talk.
Your old man's in Vegas. You tell him he ain't screwing around on you? Man, I'm giving you an opportunity of a lifetime.
What are you talking about?
To be with me.
You are absolutely
Those
deluded.
Other girls are jealous of me, and I'm offering it to you.
I wrestled, jealous?
Yes.
Of you?
Yes. I wrestled your old man and beat him for you.
Oh, my God.
There's chemistry between us.
Please, get him out of here.
Hey, why are you guys following us? We're supposed to be together here. Why are you guys following us? We need to be alone, man. You guys do your job. This is not your job.
This is a dangerous man. We're going to have a main event triangle match when we come back.
It's getting more dangerous.
All right, fans, we welcome you back to WCW Monday Nitro Live. Our sixth man is on the horizon, Horseman, against members of the Wolfpack, including Hollywood Hogan. And here are the Nitro girls. Remind you, this Saturday, January 30th.
Hey, I got a little problem here, Big Papa Punk. I know what kind of a guy you're a straight guy. I don't want to get involved in this, Big Papa Punk.
You stay right. You're more than welcome to stay right here and watch.
I'm not going to get into that.
Why don't you sit down and really enjoy yourself? Please, enjoy yourself.
Big Papa Pump, Scott Steiner, is sitting right here and watching the Nitro girls, watching Kimberly. So even though the efforts to keep him out of the dressing room have kind of been successful, he is still around everywhere she is. And of course, as we mentioned earlier, DDP not here tonight. Yeah, this transcends pro wrestling, guys. This is, you heard what DDP said, Brain, 1 week ago.
Don't start anything.
I don't think he's paying any attention to us, to be honest with you.
I noticed something. When she went by, We're lucky he's left. Just lucky he's out of here.
Wow, what a scary man.
Tell him anything. Tell him anything he wants to hear. Lie, just lie.
Let's get ready to rumble!
We have had a house full of excitement here tonight. And in the weeks to come, we're going to be telling you how this great show, Nitro, is going to be coming to the Dean Dome in Chapel Hill, North Carolina.
Coming to the ring at this time, the Team New World Order. First. 317 pounds from Phoenix, Arizona. Considered by many to be the best professional wrestling today. The master of the powerbomb jackknife, former world heavyweight champion, Big Sexy Kevin Nash. And 6 feet, 7 inches tall, 275.5 pounds from Hollywood, USA. The most famous face and name in professional wrestling history. He is the leader and driving force behind the New World Order, both Black and White and Wolfpack. Ladies and gentlemen, here is United States presidential candidate and the reigning undisputed WCW NWO heavyweight champion of the world, Hollywood.
Guys, I kind of take issue with that. I think it is a disputed title. The fact he was handed the belt by one Kevin Nash makes it a very disputed title. But nonetheless, the excitement of, and that's quite a team right there of Hogan, Nash, and Steiner to face the Horsemen. But the excitement of Nitro coming soon to the Dean Dome at Chapel Hill in Toronto at the brand new Air Canada Center. We're going to have more information on those events in the weeks to come.
Dallas, Texas! Diamond Dallas!
Wow.
As you're out in LA, California, I want you to know that out back, your wife is flirting with the Big Papa. Now, DDP, if your wife wants to tease me, she better be ready to please me.
I can say that.
But Diamond Dallas Page, as I look at you physically, I know you can't satisfy your hooch. So I'm just a man to get the job done. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
Hey, you guys, that was good. All right. It was awesome. Hey, Wes, what's our final camera shot?
Big Papa's here.
I'm here, the man of your
Scott,
dreams.
I told you to get your hands off me.
What do you mean?
Leave me alone.
I am here
Stop
for you.
Stop following me around. Paige is going to kill you.
Man, I'll beat him like a dog so I can be with you.
Get him off me. Huh? Get him off me.
Whoa.
Oh,
hey,
what are you doing? Kimberly.
Oh, shit.
You okay?
She slipped.
What's up?
All right. Come on, we need some help. We need coach. Yeah. Somebody go get
You're
coach.
Okay,
you okay?
She's out.
Y'all,
all right, fan.
She pulled back. I don't know if he pushed.
DDP, who obviously just arrived at the building. Cruiserweight champ Kidman explaining to DDP what went down here.
You can see his face. He knows what happened now.
That is, there's our locker room area. There you saw the. DDP looking at it. Uh-oh, it's NWO locker room.
Yeah, yeah,
what are you talking about? Don't I act like you're what I'm talking about. Where is he? Don't even think about moving. Sit down. What do you think is his fun? What do you think is his funny?
Spit it out, boy.
Spit it out, then.
What are you looking for?
Steiner, where is he?
That's all about talking pot.
You want to think this is funny, right?
What do you want to see Scotty for?
What's Scotty? Oh, it's a big wolf pack. Yeah. Big wolf pack want to step up and stooge off their buddy, huh? I'll tell you what, you, and you, Nash, better pray to God, especially Steiner, better pray that my wife's all right.
Oh,
what's he so mad about?
Tripping,
whoa, whoa, whoa. What do you want?
He's tripping,
he
man.
Said something about you and yeah. Kimberly. What's? Hey, I never touched her. She slipped. I swear to God. But he may be looking for this.
What the?
What the? Oh! 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 Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh!
I don't know where Paige is. Go out to wherever Paige is. Tell him that Steiner has no problem with anything he wants. If he wants a match, whatever, and do me another thing. When you get done delivering the message, smack Paige in the mouth.
Slap him. Boy. Slap him.
Go get him, Vince.
I mean,
go
just
get him,
light
Vince.
Him
Vince.
Up.
Vince. Okay. Vince, come on, baby.
Yeah.
Come on, Vince.
Yeah.
Come on, Vince. Vince.
Yes, sir.
Come on, baby.
Woo.
Wolf man. Pack, baby.
Yeah.
Where's my wife at?
Just do it.
Oh, wow.
He had me shaking him up.
Beat you to go out and tell Dallas Page that Scott Steiner will accept the match. And when he accepts the match, they want you to slap him. Have you slap him right across the face?
What?
And when you slap him, that'll be our cue to come down to help you.
Oh, you guys are coming right when I slap him.
Right, slap him right in the face. Slap the taste out of his mouth.
Oh, man, I'll do that in a heartbeat.
Okay.
Okay.
Go get it, man.
Go get it right now.
Okay. Yeah.
With who? You dunked Eric pretty darn good.
This is Minneapolis. There's ice all over the floor.
Oh, my God.
I couldn't. I lost my footing. Oh,
you got heat with Bischoff.
That is a freak.
You didn't hear that, as you're stumbling away, I should say. He's pointing to you. He said, I'll get back at you, Heenan. You're mine.
Said, I'll never forget this.
It wasn't my fault. I was going to give him the ball and show him that I didn't want to be involved in anything like this. I'm a broadcast journalist. I'm not a right-hand reliever.
It's all Craig Leather's fault, huh?
Yeah, you know, he sent me out there. He said, go take a couple shots, Sam. You know why he hates big shots.
Scott Steiner, Big Pop Pump, who has been very involved in this program tonight, but in a way that has been nothing less than totally disgusting. The World Television Champion comes out. And we saw earlier how DDP is, I hope Diamond Dallas, when he left, has gone to check on Kimberly in her condition.
As you people are mesmerized by the greatest body in the world, you can see why I am a champion. And being a champion means you gotta take on all comers. That means even white trash. Now, Diamond Dallas Page, last time we wrestled, there was one stipulation. And if I beat you, I got to show your wife what it was like to be with a real man. You heard it, the whole world heard it, and now you got a problem with it. But there was one other person that heard it, and she seems to like that stipulation, and that's your wife. Because she's in the back, flirting with me, asking questions why all my hooches say there's nothing finer than Scott Steiner. So Diamond Dallas Page, you need to step aside and let nature take its course and let this body rock your wife's body until she tells me who's her daddy. Because in one night, I will fulfill all her fantasies. Because as you can see, this body is not built just for pleasure, and you don't need no tape measure, because that is the largest arms in the world, and this body can go. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
Tony, he's got them all mesmerized.
Boy, does he ever. I've never seen so much arrogance and, I don't know. I don't know what to say. But that he'll be wrestling when we come back on Nitro Live.
Lucky day.
Life's a drag.
Roll him in for Big Papa Pump to attack him again.
Time for relaxation.
In the Steiner recliner.
He's not going anyplace. He's had it.
He wakes him off. Charles Robinson calls the bell. So Jericho had decided to walk out. Harry Saturn in the dress and all that Jericho had forced him to wear comes in, since Jericho back in the ring enabling Big Papa Pump to retain the television belt.
Pump is the stuff, and he is a freak.
Next on Nitro,
Tony, he's the greatest.
Oh my, is that Kimberly?
That's not only Kimberly. You're looking live outside. That's DDP. Oh my. Where did he come from?
They're not going to wait until Super Brawl.
Not at all. Not at all.
They were getting ready to get in the car, Kimberly and DDP, and Scott Steiner's in the car. Scott Steiner's in the car.
He's carjacked the car and Kimberly. Oh, my. Oh, no.
Oh, oh, my God!
Damn it! Now! Now!
Oh, fans.
Don't move her! up there now.
Get me the ambulance now! Get you idiot! Get him!
Come on! Oh my God! Fans!
Please.
Oh my fans! Where are we gonna do now? Where are we going?
Where's the ambulance?
Don't touch her.
It's okay. It's okay.
Let's take a commercial break.
Don't move her.
Oh my God!
Oh. Take care. Keep calm.
All right, fans, we welcome you back to the Marine, outside of the Marine Midland Arena, where we witnessed one of the most frightening scenes ever. Oh my God.
All right, great.
It's okay. Diamond's got to get out of there.
I got it.
Where's that tape?
It's in my pocket. Don't worry, I got it. Okay, this is going to be a little uncomfortable, so I apologize now.
I'm right here, baby.
You're okay.
It's going to take quite a while for them to get her out.
It's okay. All right, we're going to do the same thing, roll to my right. Okay.
One, two, three.
Just on the side.
Okay.
There you go. All right. Roll the back. Okay. Pick her up.
Put
her down. Okay. One, two, three. Right there. Just right there.
Oh, she in pain.
Thank God WCW has an ambulance backstage for the safety of the wrestlers. We never expected to see this situation with Kimberly, however. God, this looks serious.
That idiot threw her out of that moving car.
It was almost as if she was ejected out of that car, Tony.
That idiot.
The rate of speed that car, with Scott Steiner behind the wheel, sped away from the Marine Midland Arena here in Buffalo.
That man is crazy.
And that man is in a lot of trouble. And I want to say this. He's in a little bit more trouble than just getting in the ring with Paige.
It's going too far.
Come on.
I think this transcends. I think, to be honest with you,
my count, ready?
That
one, two,
charges
three.
Brought against this man will
should
be discussed, to be very honest with you. How can anyone justify acting
right
like
here,
this?
Right here, right
doing
right
like
right
this.
Here.
Right here.
Okay. Okay, ready? On up. Great. Okay.
What must be going through the mind and the stomach of that man right there?
Okay, let go of yours.
Oh.
Here we go.
I'm right here, baby.
Right here. All right, go.
Okay, give
me breath.
I'm right here, baby.
I got it.
Well, I don't know if we're going to have a... You know what? If we never see Big Papa Pump on this program again, it'll be too soon.
Hey, is Diamond Dallas Page here?
No, not tonight. Not expected.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
I told you, old man, I'd show up tonight.
The toughest. I'm buff, but he's a freak. Big Papa Pump.
Big Papa Pump finally comes back to the arena. After what we have witnessed over the past few weeks, what Diamond Dallas Page and Kimberly have had to endure, and then to put a very ugly punctuation mark on all of this, this man has the audacity to have a lawyer make a statement on Monday saying that he is going to bring up charges against DDP. Can you believe this type of justice that's going through the mind of this man?
Can you believe the gall of Scott Steiner, that attorney this past Monday on Nitro, talking about $1 million lawsuit, monetary damages because of assault and battery, the fact that they were going to subpoena Diamond Dallas Page and take him before a grand jury?
Well, I was going to interview his attorney tonight, but they said he wouldn't be back till next week. He was out chasing ambulances.
If that's the justice he's looking for, DDP's got his own brand this Sunday.
You know, Buff, I look out in the crowd, and I see people giving the Diamond Cutter sign, and I'm saying there's people out there that like Diamond Dallas Page. Then I look out and I see fans holding DDP signs, and I'm saying this might be DDP country. But then when I look way back in the cheap sheets and I see that fat, out of shape, rotten tooth, white trash, and I know I'm in DDP country. Now the biggest white trash in WCW, Diamond Dallas Trash, who Tony Schiavone calls the People's Champion, was afraid to show up tonight. But I hear he wants to fight me at Super Brawl because he found out that his wife likes me not only for my body, but for my personality. He found out that his wife figured out that Diamond Dallas Page could live 1,000 lifetimes with his genetics and never look this great. So Diamond Dallas Page, you want to fight me at Super Brawl? You got it. But I'm going to raise the stakes. I'm going to raise the stipulation. Because last time I wrestled you, I said if I beat you, I would show your wife what it was like to be with a real man. This time, if I beat you at Super Brawl, I get your wife for 30 days. 30. But DDP, this stipulation comes with a warning, because the last streak that I had with one of my freaks for 30 days and 30 nights was 4 years ago, and she still calls me 3 times a day, and her nickname for me is the Big Bad Booty Daddy. Because all my hooches know that the nighttime is prime time for the Big Papa. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
So he wants to add a stipulation that he would get a cavalry.
Now since Diamond Dallas Page
for 30 days,
was afraid to show up tonight, I want to beat up somebody. So WCW, send somebody down here because I'm not leaving.
Scott Steiner. The
Bagwell
man is awesome.
Bagwell returning to the ring.
Belly to belly.
That just makes the NWO stronger with Buff Bagwell getting his doctor's release and claiming that he's ready to return to action.
And now it's the Steiner recliner.
Sit back and relax, Mr. Blaze.
And immediately Bobby Blaze gives up.
Good move.
Wait, hold on now. He dropped him to pick him up again.
Hey, Bobby, how you feel?
He's gonna black out.
That sounded like Kimberly.
This is all really distasteful from, but it's what we expect from these two guys. Boy, I cannot wait till Sunday, till DDP gets his hands around the throat of Scott Steiner.
Remember this too, Schiavone, this is no pushover. He's gonna be ready. He won't be in the same mind gear as DDP, but he's gonna be ready. It's gonna be a great fight, a great fight.
And it's good that the medical staff were quick to come out. And they're going to, I'm sure, yeah,
Bobby Blaze is going to be sent out of here.
Get him out of here before he gets him again.
That's exactly what has to happen.
Oh, come on, enough of this.
You know, Brain, who can stop this man? I mean, can Diamond Dallas do it?
He's going to have to. You're in good hands with Steiner.
This is absolutely horrible, and we're going to be right back. Oh, not again. We'll be back.
Relax.
You get a lot of freaks on that bus.
Especially with the two best buddies in the business.
It's time to get hard, man. It's time to get lean, McMahon. Do you want help?
Whoa, easy, easy. You okay?
Thanks.
You got everything under control?
Just another damsel in distress, Scotty.
Hey.
Tough. Wow, I look good.
Hey.
Hey, what's up?
Thanks for helping me out earlier today.
No problem.
Why don't you guys come and see me later?
Cool.
Wow. Well, it looks like we're doing double duty tonight.
What do you mean by that?
Work out during the day, and we're working out tonight.
This is it. This is the place.
All right.
Miss Candy, let's go. You think Candy's here yet? I know it.
Hello, boys.
This can't be the right place.
Let's get out of here.
Hey, boys, you sure you're in the right place?
I'm gonna kill him.
No, Scotty, no.
Hey, nice club. Nice hair.
Scotty, where's the Hummer?
That
Hummer?
Blonde just traveled your Hummer.
A blonde.
Race you to rally.
What does that mean? Come on, let's go.
Hey, you fat slob. Instead of taking a picture of this punk, why don't you take a picture of a real man? Hey, cover. You see what I did, Paige?
I look like Paige.
Well, get ready, because you're next. Keep those straps out, boy!
He's got a big mouth. One of these days, I'm going to shut it right down his throat.
As we go back to the ring here on Monday. Oh, that's all we need to see.
Yes!
Last time we saw them, they were lost in San Francisco somewhere. Why didn't they stay lost?
They're still lost, believe it or not.
Oh, yeah, baby!
The World of Television champion and Papa Pump, Scott Steiner. And his right-hand man, what do we call him, Mike? His flunky,
We call him Buff Bagwell, who has his doctor's release and is prepared to return to professional wrestling in-ring action. That's what we call him, and he also played a role last night in Super Brawl 9 in the victory by Big Papa Pump Scott Steiner over Diamond Dallas Page. We really don't have any further update as to how long DDP is going to be out of action, but he was stretchered from the arena last night and obviously needed medical attention after Scott Steiner just continued to work over the neck and refusing to break that Steiner recliner on DDP.
He was stretchered twice last night. First time they put him on, then Big Papa Pump, you remember, knocked him off into the rail around there.
Helps the lady into the ring, does Big Papa Pump, but you're right, Mike. Report on DDP is he is sore. He's no serious damage, but he's going to be out for a while here before he can get back in the ring. And I guess that's what Scott Steiner wanted.
Cut the music! You see, when Big Papa Pump comes to town, all my hooches come around. Now, you Sacramento scumbags, all you Sacramento white trash that are waiting for Diamond Dallas Page to show up, he's not coming, because I put him in the hospital. I gave Diamond Dallas Trash fair warning that he wasn't big enough, he wasn't strong enough, and he wasn't smart enough to take on a great athlete like myself. But he let his ego get in the way of things, and he wanted to defend the honor of his wife Now I get the honor to get honor and offer for 30 days and 30 nights.
That's not true. That's a lie.
And she will tell me that I'm the daddy. Now, Diamond Dallas Page, after those 30 days and 30 nights of taking your wife to Nirvana, she will call me Big Bad Booty Daddy. So as you're in the hospital on your back screaming in pain, your wife will be on her back screaming my name. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me. I'm not done yet.
Oh, great.
Now the NWO is the number one organization in sports, and our number one objective is to put WCW out of business. Now I've hurt my brother, I've hurt Diamond Dallas Page, and if I could fight Sting, I would hurt him. So that means there's only one guy left, and that's you, Goldberg. Ooh. Now I see all these signs that say, Goldberg, who's next? Goldberg, you're next on my list. You see, you accept my challenge and meet me here because believe me, the man with the largest arms in the world, it's not hard to find. I'm just hard. Just ask my hooches. Goldberg, I'm putting you in the hospital right next to Diamond Dallas Page tonight.
Wow.
Now turn the music on.
This is all gone to his head. Come out here and he wants Goldberg.
Ladies and gentlemen,
let's get ready to rumble!
Scott Steiner claimed that he was going to put Goldberg in the hospital beside DDP. And as you might imagine, it didn't take long
coming
for the
to
answer
the ring
to come.
At this time, he's 6'3" and weighs 282 pounds. In the company of his NWO Wolfpack associate, Mr. Buff Bagwell is one of the most physically imposing and powerful human beings ever to climb through the ropes in wrestling history. Representing the reign of terror imposed by the red and black of the NWO Wolfpack on the WCW, his latest victim, DDP, last night at Super Brawl 99. Ladies and gentlemen, from the Motor City, Detroit, Michigan, here is the master of the Steiner recliner, the man with the biggest guns in wrestling today, Big Papa Pump, Scott Steiner.
This is really going to be a battle now. I do need to let you know that we do understand that because of the quickness of the turnaround of this verbal contract, it's going to be not, will be.
Cut the music off.
Will not be for the television belt.
Number one, there's only one Buff in this world, and you ain't got the stuff. There's no reason for you to even be out here anymore because Goldberg's not here. I've searched this building from top to bottom, just like Big Papa Pump asked me to, and Goldberg's not gonna show. You're not gonna see the sparkles. You're not gonna see Goldberg. So beat it.
Now, since I can't beat up Goldberg, why don't some of you white trash get in a ring, because I'm going to fight somebody.
I don't know if they know something we don't or what's going on here, but we...
Come on, somebody be a man and step in the ring.
We certainly expected Goldberg to... We'll stay, hang on here.
Yeah, how about you, man? You've been talking trash all night. Get in here. Come on. Now's your chance. Come on. What is stopping you? Come on.
Fans, I don't...
Just like WCW, you're all scared.
I've been told we're still going to go to Ricky Rackman, but here comes Buff Bagwell in the World Television Champion. Big Papa Pump.
Look at that bad boy right there. Look at that. Jimmy.
They're all arrogant right now, but... You can't deny what we just saw, Mike. What Goldberg and Rick Steiner did 1 week ago.
Well, there were a couple of auspicious returns 1 week ago tonight on Nitro. One of them involved that first man there, Buff Bagwell, among his first in-ring action in months and months as he was met by a Goldberg spear, as well as the return of the brother of this man, Big Papa Pump. Yeah, it was the dog-faced gremlin, Rick Steiner, who came back with a bang on Nitro last Monday.
But they had somebody, Scotty Steiner, didn't want to see, and that was Big Brother. Now that they're going to the ring, can we go to the live cut-in?
No, that's not my choice there, Living Legend. I certainly would love to,
just
but...
Just a suggestion to anybody in the truck.
Now, we need to hang with this to see exactly what these two men are going to say. Of course, remember how that was all set up last week, where right now on the heels of Super Brawl, Scott Steiner told Goldberg he's going to put him in the hospital right beside of Diamond Dallas Page. And that never happened.
As I look at you, tobacco-chewing scumbag rednecks, tonight, you're not gonna see your so-called People's Champion, Diamond Dallas Trash. Because I put him in the hospital, so I was gonna come out here and be a nice guy and say, tonight, I'll be your role model. But the fact of the matter is, all I see out there is genetic junk. And what you're looking at is a genetic freak. And there's not one of you scumbags that could grow up and be like me.
Well, they're chanting one name that could be bigger than him.
So just give it up. You guys will always be losers in Chapel Hill.
You know that's going to be answered.
Goldberg, you've got size, but you don't have my size. You don't have the largest arm in the world. Tonight, I'm going to show you for what you really are, a bunch of hype for WCW. You're not good enough to be in the NWO. Who's next? Who cares? Hit the music.
Scott Steiner and Buff Bagwell want Goldberg and Rick Steiner tonight here on Nitro. Now let's go to our spring breakout party and Ricky Rackman. They started in Sacramento, of course, last week.
And they're making their way across country, all the way to Raleigh during the week. There's Big Papa Pump driving that bus.
Who would have let him drive?
And gorgeous ladies all around, as you might imagine with that duo, wherever they are.
You think he toots when drivers are in front of him or just bumps them in the butt and pushes them off the road?
And then, of course, the Hummer.
Ooga, ooga.
All over, coast to coast, state to state, until we finish up on the 22nd of March at Club La Vila. It's WCW Monday Nitro's Road to Spring Breakout.
Somebody call a cab?
Tucky. Ladies and gentlemen, as Buff Bagwell and Big Papa Pump make their way out, we also found out from our good friend Jimmy Barron, who's one of the announcers on our Nitro Backstage Blast the first Monday of every month, that he talked to the championship committee. And they've also added now a handicap match where the Cat and Sonny Ono together will face Jerry Flynn at Uncensored. So we've had a lot of matches added to the big card tonight. It's going to be spectacular on the 14th of March.
The committee's working overtime, but so is Ric Flair. You know what I loved about what Flair said? This isn't a challenge to Hollywood Hogan. I'm telling him, as president of WCW, that they are going to have that steel cage match in 13 days.
Gentlemen, just listen to me right now. Forget Papa Pump and everything else. Did you notice when Ric Flair was in the ring? And if you guys don't understand what I'm saying, ask him to roll the tape back to you later. His eyes were watered. He's still thinking about his son, what happened. I've never seen Ric Flair in this kind of a mood in my life. He's the last man I managed. I've known him since he started in this sport, and I've never seen him like this.
Well, you know what? I don't want to disagree with you, but I don't think he was thinking about his son. I think he's gotten over that. I think he's thinking about Hogan. I think he feels that Hogan is the root of this whole evil.
You're right, Tony. That's what I meant. Hogan was responsible for everything that happened to him. But he showed sorrow in his eyes. He was hurt. You could just see it. And when he's hurt, he's dangerous.
And he will be dangerous in 13 days. When we come back, Goldberg comes out with Rick Steiner. We'll get it on in our main event live from Chapel Hill.
Mickey J down and out in the corner. Booker T in total control of this matchup. He was in the driver's seat. Clothesline sends Bagwell out to the floor. Double axe handle off the ring apron from Booker T.
I hear something, gentlemen.
Well, now it is Booker T, and it's a ringing in his ears because he was clobbered by Big Papa Pump.
From behind, he never saw it coming.
The World Television Champion, Big Papa Pump, wiped out Booker T with the referees back down, turned around from the inadvertent Harlem sidekick. He may be going for his blockbuster here. If he can position the man right, yep, that's what it is.
Buff blockbuster, there it is. He's got him.
Mickey J is back up, revived by Big Papa Pump. And it's over, yes it is. Buff Bagwell wins thanks to Big Papa Pump and the chair here on Thunder. And Booker T is going to have a headache to remember for a few days now. What will happen in the next chapter heading to Uncensored between Hollywood Hogan and Ric Flair? We'll find out Monday live on Nitro and see you in 2 days on Saturday night.
Look at the way these guys are driving Sasha Staples. They're all over the road.
Got it. I know a lot of cops in Boston. I think we're cool. Tell me you're from Boston.
Yeah. Roll the window down a little more, sir.
Yeah.
Afternoon. I'm stopping you for a radical operation.
All right.
See a license, please?
License? License plates in the back of the
okay,
the
let's home. Both of you guys step out of the vehicle, okay?
Oh, come on, man.
Right, step right to the rear. You know who these two are? That's Buff Bagwell.
That's Big Papa Pump.
Yeah. I got a good idea. I think you guys can help us out. I think what I'll do, Sergeant White, is I'll give them a couple of these ticket books, and they can go out, and they can give us some good quality police work while they're here in Boston, and we'll see how they do with that.
You can go by Sergeant Staples' rules, or you can go by my rules.
What's your rules?
If you go by my rules, we'll take you back to the barracks right now.
You're saying if we do some police work here, you're saying we can get off the hook here.
We don't argue, gentlemen. Take your pick.
Well, that's easy.
Can we get a hat?
Give you a badge.
And a hat?
A badge. You got a beautiful hat on.
No smoking,
hey.
Ma'am.
Hey.
Ma'am, please, come here for a second.
What's that say?
State police.
State police, ma'am.
I know.
Zip it, beat it,
pay the fine, and get out of here.
If you have a nice day, though.
If you do the crime, you better pay the fine. Buff, when this criminal comes, you want to be Starsky or you want to be Hutch?
I'm going to be Hutch.
You're Hutch. Yo.
Hey, yeah. Pal.
What's up?
What's that say?
Time expired?
Why is it expired?
Had no change, guys.
Yeah, no change. Come on.
Right.
I see about that. Turn him upside down. You got change.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah,
you got
change. You're stealing from the system, boy.
Hutch!
Wow.
Right in front of me. What is that?
It's a badge.
What is that?
We're G-Man.
That's Starsky, I'm Hutch. What does this say?
It's a ticket book.
That's exactly what you're fixing to get, pal.
But I meant to...
Yeah, right. Tell your story, Walkers.
Oh. Yeah.
I know. You didn't mean to do it, right? Beat it.
Well, Sergeant Stables, look who's back.
How you guys doing?
All right.
Doing pretty good.
We free to go?
You're free to go. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
All right. See you.
Take care.
A couple of nice guys. Not bad.
Each other on top of the limousines. We've had a dog collar match. A guy came out wrapped in barbed wire. Ric Flair comes out, slaps Goldberg, grabbing his son by the lapel, and he's mad at his son, and now he's mad at Goldberg, and now he's possessed of becoming 14-time world champ and becoming the president forever. And I don't know what to make of all this. I just know that it's all going to be settled and uncensored, I think.
That's what I was going to say. It can mean only one thing. Uncensored is 6 days away. Everybody's losing it.
Have you lost it yet, Living Legend?
No, I'm driving him long and straight.
Well, I can tell you.
Hey. Yes, I made a chance to pick it right. I'm the best celebrity pro golfer on the planet.
And if you don't, you're going to hear it here from your cohort. Meanwhile, Big Papa Pump and Buff Bagwell come to the ranch. Now remember how we ended Thunder, Mike Tenay, on Thursday night.
Tony, it was a main event matchup involving Booker T against Buff Bagwell. And that man, Big Papa Pump Scott Steiner, interfered in the match with a chair. He nailed Booker T. That allowed Buff Bagwell to score the win. Tonight, Booker T has an opportunity to go into the ring against the world television champion.
You know, when I come out here, all you people boo me. Because I ain't tell the truth, and all you people can't handle the truth. But I call it as I see it, and what I'm seeing right now is a bunch of genetic deficient scumbags who are a disgrace to the human race. Then I see a couple of pencil necks that go to the gym, pump a little iron, to hope they one day look as great as I do. And I'm saying, give it up. Take that $30 that you're wasting on a membership, buy a case of beer, sit on a sofa, turn on a TV set, and look at the greatest body in the world. Do what I do best. Because there's nobody here in Wooster, there's nobody on the TV watching right now that could ever duplicate the largest peaks in the world because I'm a genetic freak. So it's no wonder when Big Papa Pump comes to town, all the hooches come around and it's like taking candy from a baby. Because they all want to spread the word, because there's nothing finer than Scott Steiner. And I guarantee you by the end of the night, somebody will call me the Big Bad Booty Daddy. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
Big Scotty Weiner.
Pulled him down, straddled the turnbuckle, that solid steel turnbuckle, and I think really maybe kissed the side of that turnbuckle with that right knee as well.
There's the recliner.
The Steiner recliner's on.
Not good.
The same move that injured DDP last month in Oakland.
Come on.
He's trying to fight it. Look at his eyes. Can he fight it?
he's unconscious.
No,
no he's not!
Yes. Yeah, he did go out. I thought it was a last-ditch effort, those hands and the throat that time. But he did go out. He went out unconscious. Didn't give up. Out cold, Booker T. And Scott Steiner retains the television belt. Oh, no. Now they shell the referee.
Uh-oh. The dangerous work environment continues. Steel chair to the back.
They're going to whack a man who's out, who's unconscious. The only thing they're trying to prove here.
NWO.
Not only is he still the champ, but he, I guess he wants to say that, hey, I can put Booker T the same place I put DDP.
Well, the only thing he can say is that him and Bagwell beat Booker T.
Bubba Bumps, your hookup. Holla if you hear me.
Unfortunately, we hear you all too loud and clear. Physical matchup. Can't deny that. And we're going to go back and take a look at some of the action that went down to this match. Comes out, that could mean anything. Absolutely anything. And it means Buff Bagwell.
And you know what that means? Who he's usually with.
Yeah, the world, former world television champion, Big Papa Pump. So here they come. It gives us a moment to let you know this Friday, the 19th of March. Tickets go on sale for the April 28th event of World Championship Wrestling in Pittsburgh at the AJ Palumbo Center. Tickets go on sale this Friday, the 19th. At the box office and all Ticketmaster outlets. Plus, the Disco Inferno will be at the box office, or the Giant Eagle, that is, in McIntyre Square Shopping Center from 10 a.m. till noon to sign your autographs. The tickets go on sale for Pittsburgh this coming Friday.
Well, it certainly wasn't the Wolfpack's night last evening at Uncensored, because not only did Ric Flair beat Hollywood Hogan for the World Heavyweight title, but it was Booker T knocking off this man, the genetic freak, Big Papa Pump Scott Steiner, to win the TV belt when a Buff Bagwell chair shot went awry.
But Booker T earned it. He took it to him. He didn't back away. It was a darn good fight. And it could have gone either way at any time.
Sure it could have. And let's say this. We talked about this earlier when Booker T first arrived to the arena here at the First Star Center. That, yeah, Big Papa Pump is a phenomenal athlete. Take a look at his body. But I don't think, pound for pound, you're going to find a better athlete in any walk of life, in any sport, than Booker T. Booker T's win last night, to me, was his comeback full circle. From the injuries he's received, I think Booker T being a champion just fits in the sport.
You know, he's been tag team champion many times. Last night, like you said, I saw in that man, he could win any title at any time, just given the opportunity.
Absolutely, Brain, you're right.
Of course I'm right, I'm the Brain.
Scumbags from Cincinnati! It's obvious that we don't live in a perfect world, but you're looking at a perfect body. You're looking at a genetic freak. And now, since the Cincinnati Bengals suck, the Cincinnati Reds suck, athlete in Cincinnati right now. For some action, the big bad Booty Daddy will give you satisfaction. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump, as you hook up, holler if you hear me. Now, since we're talking about perfection, we might as well talk about the NWO Black and Red, because we are the greatest athletes in the world today. And I'm talking body and mind. But you see, last night, somebody fumbled. Somebody made a mental error. And I'm talking to you, Buff. See, since your neck injury, I taught you how to train, and you've trained your body, but it's obvious you haven't changed your brain. Because you not only cost me, you cost the NWO, Jack. No, no, I'm talking to you, boy.
Don't go here.
I'm saying since you got a pencil neck and you hurt your neck, you're not the same, and maybe you don't belong anymore.
Well, since we're getting things off our chest, Big Papa Pump, maybe you want to scan the crowd and look at the Buff Daddy signs.
There's a lot of them.
See, that's the difference. You care about the crowd. I don't give a damn about any of these fans.
You know what, Scotty? For the last 3 months, I've been coming out here. I walk down that aisle, big man, and I make you look like $1 million. But you know what? Since Buff Daddy has got back into shape, maybe Scotty is a little bit jealous. Just a little bit.
Remember one thing, as good as you look, you will always be second best next to me.
Scotty, this is getting a little bit out of the hand, but let's just be honest. You're Big Papa Pump, but you're not Buff, and you're not the stuff.
Let me remind you one thing. Before you join the NWO, you were nothing. If we kick you out, you'll be nothing again.
You know what? This is getting a little bit out of hand, Scotty, okay? Let's settle down, okay? We don't need this, okay, big man? I told you last night I was sorry. I'll tell you again I'm sorry. But if you got a problem with that, you need to let me know right now. This is getting a little out of hand. Let's just drop it, okay? Let's let it go. What do you say, Cincinnati?
Well, they patched that up. No, they didn't. Gonna say they patched that up, but...
Well, if he turned on his brother and his family, why wouldn't he Bagwell?
Oh, he's got a tear. Oh, no. Now let's not forget that Bagwell's neck was seriously injured about a year ago. He needs to, and he's going to cross the back near the neck.
He is totally
out of control. Buff signs now. Show the buff sign.
Is this guy out of control?
Oh, he's quick. Oh, no. He's not going to be able to take this.
Pulling back on the neck.
Not this.
What a freaking kick.
This is a permanent injury.
He could be paralyzed for life. Somebody stop him.
Oh, no.
Oh, we've been talking about how dangerous this man is, but he's gone over the line tonight.
He can't be brought back. This man needs mental help.
You and all your fans suck.
Well, obviously, Bagwell's out, and it just remains to be seen the extent of any injuries here.
No, you
I've never seen so much hate in a man in my life.
He is a completely out of control. Completely out of our fans. I'm told we are going to take a commercial break. Someone get this guy out of here. It's underway. We send it to the one, the only, Mr. Scoop, Mr. Know-It-All, Mr. Dirt himself. I know it, you don't.
Thank you, Johnny.
Smart Aleck, Mike today, with a hotline plug. Go ahead, Mike.
Well, you know, guys, everywhere we go, the two people that wrestling fans ask us about maybe more than any would be Sting and Randy Savage. Well, we will try to shed some light on the whereabouts of those two individuals, as well as bring you up to date with all the latest news from around the world of professional wrestling on the WCW hotline. And that report is up now at 1-900-909-9900, $1.69 a minute. Kids, get your parents' permission, but check out the hotline now.
Where do you get all your information?
Sources. Contacts.
If I'm a, if I'm a Goldberg.
Cut the music.
Or I'm a Kevin Nash, would you tell me? If I threaten to powerbomb you?
I want all you women out here to close your eyes and visualize in your mind your idea of the perfect man. Close your eyes and fantasize about a man with a perfect body. And I'm saying when you open your eyes, the man that was just in your mind stands right before you in your eyes. So all you hooches out there that are wishing that you could be kissing this genetic freak, and you want me to put the hammer down, I'll be your missionary man, because the nighttime is prime time for the big bad Booty Daddy. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
I guess that's the direct method. Holler if you hear me. Over the top.
I don't think
it's over, Jack.
He can only squeal right now, I think. That trick knee of his, yeah. It went out on him.
And the recliner, but look at Jericho fighting
Jericho giving it his all, fighting him off, but he's got it on. He's got it on.
To go either.
Jericho, he's waving, he's saying that's it. Man, you got to give him credit for winning, and he's a magnificent athlete. Either man could have advanced, but I'm really, in many ways, tough to see.
That's a freak,
a low blow like that have an impact in a match. What was a good wrestling match up until then?
And along with Ming, he advances in the U.S.
Baby,
title tournament. Does Big Papa Pump.
We're coming back with Ric Flair against Rey Mysterio Jr. for the world title. It's only on Nitro.
Look up!
That's the Wolfpack music. What do you
I
mean,
know what it is. It's not named that tune.
Is this on your format?
Nothing's on my format.
We're going to the next match. It's a double match segment. Excitement reigns.
It's the new Nitro, Tony.
It's the new Nitro. Let's stay on all night.
Now I got to fight those two dozen eggs. But I'll stay up for a while. Looks like he's got about five dozen eggs in that arm right there.
One of the most magnificent bodies, not only in professional wrestling, but in the entire sports world. And not only that, he knows it, Brain.
And everybody else knows it, like him or not. You can sit in the top seats and ringside. There's no doubt about it. This man probably has the greatest physique in all sports today.
How do you like being at ringside?
Let's be ringside. You're not
gonna cozy down here, waving all the fans.
Well, I've never really pictured you and I being cozy, but it is nice down here because you're close to the action. You can hear them sweat. I mean, say things to each other.
You can hear them sweat. You almost said you can hear them sweat.
Swear.
Swear. Well,
I like that.
Yeah, we worked up with that.
One guy gets the other guy mad, or this guy gets mad, and this guy gets this guy. It's just great. It's just great action.
Threatening poor David Fenter.
Why not?
Cut the music. As I look at all you desert-dwelling, genetic-deficient scumbags, tonight I say you got somebody to cheer for. You got the biggest white trash in WCW here, and I'm talking about Diamond Dallas Trash. Now last week on Nitro, Diamond Dallas Page came out here and said two statements, and he told two lies. One, that he wanted revenge against me. Well, Diamond Dallas Trash, if you wanted revenge against me, why didn't you get in a U.S. tag tournament for the U.S. belt, and then we would have met in the finals? Because I got to question your sincerity, boy. Now, the other lie he told was when I beat him, I would get his wife for 30 days and 30 nights. Now, Diamond Dallas Page, even though you didn't agree with it, you had 7 days by the time I made that statement, by the time we wrestled, to disagree, and that will hold up in a court of law. But you see, right now, that's neither here or there, because all my hooches are on my roller coaster of love. And I don't have 30 days and 30 nights for your wife. I don't have 30 days and 30 nights to show you why all the hooches say there's nothing finer than Scott Steiner. I don't have 30 days and 30 nights to show your wife what a physical phenomenon I really am. But all I need is one night to have your wife call me for the rest of her life the big bad booty daddy. So Diamond Dallas Page, we all gotta make sacrifices in our life. And this one goes like this. If you want revenge against me, you're gonna have to give up your wife for one night. And you, my friend, will be nothing more than a memory. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
There it is. It's Steiner. Steiner. And then the low blow stunner.
It's a good way. It's a nice call.
He beat him. Ming was all tied up in the ropes. Steiner was all tied up in the ropes. And Steiner, Big Papa Pump wins.
And how about that? In the clutches of the Tonga Death Grip, Big Papa Pump advances now for Spring Stampede this Sunday. And he'll await the winner of Jericho and Booker T later on here tonight.
But Ming never had it on him real good. He didn't have it on him that long. Steiner let him. Well, here, I'll show you here.
Why don't you show me, Brain?
Okay, roll it, guys. Hello, am I on?
Unfortunately, testing.
Steiner here showing how powerful this man is. Takes Ming over the top. Now drops him. Puts his feet on the ropes for the 1, 2, 3. Didn't get caught. That's okay with me. There's your winner. Big Papa Pump.
Is that what you had to show us?
Well, I'm not in the truck. I'm working without a net, you know.
A brand new Nitro, Scott Steiner.
Congratulations, you're the world champion. But guess what? You owe the Macho Man.
And don't you forget it.
Whatever. You're no champion, boy. You're scumbag. You're trash. You're out your mouth, boy. What a champion you are. I'm going to be champion 23. You
Monday Nitro, live from the Evergreen State in the state of Washington. For the first time ever, we're being the state of Washington. And it's Wolfpack music, and here he comes. You said, Brain, that you feel that Scott Steiner, the U.S. champ, will win the world title tonight from Diamond Dallas Page. You made that prediction.
I just feel that. He's on such a roll. The way he won the title last night, the way he intimidates people. And don't forget, in the back of DDP's mind, is what he thinks that Scott Steiner did to his leg. But he's not going to get in the ring and have an average wrestling match hold against hold. Uh-uh, not tonight.
What an intimidating figure he is coming to the ring.
He's a smart one in the family.
Now, fans, we'll let you know the match is not ready to go yet. But we're giving the U.S. champ a chance to come out and talk. So, Pinter, do us all a big favor. Hand the mic to him and then split. You understand?
No, better yet, hand your hand in the mic and then spit in his face.
Yeah, go ahead, Dave. I dare you. Oh, he's got his own mic. Better for you, man.
Cut the music! You know, I knew coming to Yakima and finding a pretty woman was like finding a needle in a haystack. But I'm not gonna let this godforsaken town rain on my parade, because I'm gonna find me a freak, put her on a leash, and get my release. Because the bottom line is, the big bad booty daddy is ready to put on a body rocking, knee knocking, cherry popping showdown. And the show don't stop till the show topper's on top. And you're telling me who's the daddy? So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me. Now, as you people look at the greatest body in the world, and you look at the greatest champion in the world, after tonight, there's only gonna be one champion, and that's me, because Diamond Dallas Page, if you think you impressed me by winning a world title, you've got another thing coming. Because if I said it once, I've said it 1,000 times. You're not big enough, you're not strong enough, and you're not smart enough to be a man like me, because you're white trash. So So after tonight, Diamond Dallas Page, I'm going to take your wife and make her feel the real deal and show her that size does matter. I'm going to take your world title and I'm going to change your world, because after tonight, I'm going to be the world champion. And then I'm going to do whatever I please.
NWO.
He has made this very personal. He has turned this into what we already knew it was, Brain, more than a world title bout. Scott Steiner, Big Papa Pump, the most explosive wrestler in our sport. Have you heard the news? Because it's imminent. It's coming up on this program. Now you hear the Wolfpacks in the house, but also in the house, Kevin Nash. Tonight, live, Ric Flair. A very unstable Ric Flair, I might add, in this program. They'll go at it. And Diamond and Dallas Page, the heavyweight champion of the world, will face Goldberg, a man who could dethrone Diamond Dallas Page in what could be one of the shortest-lived title reigns in recent memory.
Where I witnessed the history-making television tonight, and what has Papa Pump got now?
Whatever he wants.
Holler if you hear me.
I hear him. Another great reason for being at ringside. We're close to those girls.
Boy, step through those ropes.
Yeah, they can. Yes, sir. Another great reason for being here, right, Brain? Brain?
Huh? What?
You're slobbering.
Leave me alone. I don't want to talk to you and watch this at the same time.
Cut the music. You see, when Big Papa Pump comes to town, all my hooches come around. And tonight, the greatest body in the world is gonna rock some buddies until they call me the Big Bad Booty Daddy. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me. Now, Marcus Alexander Bagwell, your ego is so big, it's blurring your vision of reality. Because the fact of the matter is, a guy whose biggest claim to fame was putting on a G-string and being a male dancer didn't belong in the NWO no more, and nobody else disagreed with me. So when I got tired of having a cheerleader and I got tired of having a knucklehead being around and I left you laying, didn't you notice nobody came to help you? Because the reality of your world is, when you were born, your mother wanted a girl, but she got you. I'm saying you've got issues, Bagwell. You've got toys in the attic, broken toys, because real men don't wax their eyebrows, and real men aren't Chippendale dancers. So remember this, Bagwell, before you were ever invited into the NWO, you were nothing, and we named you Buff. And now that I kicked you out, I suggest you change your name to fit your feminine personality. I say, boy, Bagwell is hot. Boy, Bagwell is flaming, and it fits you like a glove. And I'm gonna enjoy beating the hell out of you.
time of the day night.
We'll have to wait and see. Big man, Norton. Big, big, tough man.
So Norton's going to get a U.S. title shot? Is that how it ends?
And I'm getting out of here. This dude's going to go on the floor.
You're going to stay right here is what you're going to do. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know how to explain this, although that being said, top of the program. Here he comes, the United States heavyweight champ, who cannot look past now Scott Norton into Buff Bagwell coming up at Slammarine with the U.S. title.
You can never look by Scott Norton. This is going to be a tough man. Very tough match for Big Papa Pump. Another day at the beach for Norton. Another good fight.
This plus Flair and Nash. This plus Goldberg and Page for the world. They said it so many times, I know I've said it. Stay away from this man at ringside. He's a very unstable, volatile individual.
I'll watch it for you.
You are the man. The world is going on here.
Nice, nice. Give this to the timekeeper. Don't lose it.
Wow, that man's a scary individual.
I can see his eyes through those glasses. There's nothing in there.
Next time I'm going to stun me. I'm going to move next time.
That's it.
Norton's had enough.
You know, that means could be trying to shoulder break him. The referee got plunked in the eye. And then Norton got plunked.
Nowhere's near the eye.
Belly to belly.
Count him.
Scott Steiner telling the referee to count him. And he beat him. Heavyweight title. That'll be on Sunday, May 9th.
That's a long time.
Brought to you by 1010 220 and available on pay-per-view. But next, that's right, the four big letters. He's in the ring, and whatever he wants, we do.
I got a message for you, Roddy Piper. Real men don't wear skirts. And I'm in the NWO, and I don't take anything from the WCW officials. I do what I want to do. But I like that matchup with the Macho Man, because Macho Man, if you beat me, you're the newest champ. But if I beat you, I get to take your freak and show her what it's like to be with a real Macho Man.
Well, making those stipulations as you go.
So Macho Man, if you want to take on the man with the largest arms in the world, get your butt down here, because I'm going to trash you.
Action like we've seen tonight.
We have always been the best of friends over the years. I need a huge favor, brother. Nash tonight, anything.
Don't worry about Nash. I got my own agenda with Nash. Nash is mine.
Promise me.
I got you. I got you,
brother. You're a three-time national champion, brother. Six-time All-American.
I'm with
Nash.
Nash.
Don't you promise?
Don't you worry about me.
Please, Nash. You promise me? Nash. Nash Piper.
Let's go fight. Let's get him,
make some noise!
Hey, Ray, you see Nash?
You saw him in there,
he's in here. Hey, boy!
The Steiner brothers.
So you're right about that.
Well, Michigan's good, but Minnesota's great. There's a big difference between good and great.
Well, like you told me, it's a bigger ammo.
The Steiners have reformed. The Steiners are back together, and I really think it'll go down as one of the more shocking developments of 1990.
Cut the music!
Listen up, Schiavone.
Okay, well, do what he wants.
You better.
First off, I want to apologize to all my female fans watching on TV, because tonight I didn't come here to Greenville to wrestle. Tonight I came to Greenville to find me a freak. And believe me, when the big bad booty day's on top, I keep it tight and I don't stop until you say boom shakalaka. Whisper something nice, and I'll make you scream twice. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me. Now, in case any of you saw, you scumbags from Greenville, all you rednecks from Greenville haven't figured out.
Good point.
My brother's with me now, so bow down to the United States heavyweight champion. Bow down to the U.S. TV champion. But most importantly, bow down to the greatest tag team that ever lived.
He's got them all.
Now me and my brother are back together because he finally came around to my way of thinking, because WCW sucks.
Good point.
We got the commissioner.
Wait a minute.
Running around in a dress, which may be a big hit in the Red Lake District, but you wouldn't last 2 seconds in Detroit. And then you got the president of WCW in the psychiatric ward getting shock treatment. So from now on, my brother's with me in the NWO, black and red.
And what about Tank Abbott in a week ago? And what happened to Sting?
Shut up!
Talking to you, Tony.
I believe so.
I'll be with you later on tonight, baby. You see, all my hooches have a space to fill, and they all tell me I'm the big thrill. So believe me, when I'm between the sheets and I'm pushing the pink, there isn't a freak that ever think that I'm just an ordinary man. They'll know I'm Superman, because I am the big bad Red Booty Daddy. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
They hear him.
Now Sting, last week when my brother was beating the hell out of you in Houston, I was in the back seeing if you had any friends in WCW that were gonna come out and help you. I was in the back seeing if in WCW had any real men that wanted to face the Steiner brothers. But it's obvious you're on your own. But come this Sunday night, Sting, at the pay-per-view, my brother's gonna be there. And where he's at, I'm at. And if you don't have any friends there, Sting, I'm gonna show you. The dog-faced gremlin's gonna show you why we're the most feared tag team in the world. We're gonna show you why we're the greatest tag team that ever lived.
I'm Larry Zbysko. I'm here with Scott Steiner, Big Papa Pump, of course, a man we haven't seen for a few months now, and a man faced wrestling's biggest nightmare, severe back injury. Scott, I got to ask you, what caused the injury?
Well, Larry, about a year and a half ago, I hurt my back, but I came back from it. But this May, I had three screws put in my shoulder, and I had to wear a brace, which caused me to lean to the left, which re-aggravated those three ruptured discs. So ever since that soldier surgery, I've been in severe pain.
And you talk about pain, Scott, and that's the common denominator between, you know, a wrestler's career going on or being ended. But there had to be a last straw. I mean, what was the final, you know, point when you said to yourself, I mean, I can't take it anymore. I've got to get the surgery.
Well, I opted to, you know, try to every option I could to try not to have surgery. You know, I had six epidurals, you know, and every time you have epidurals, it had caused severe headache. Then I had nerve blocks, but it just kept, the pain kept on coming back after every one. So I just had to get out of pain. So I had to, you know, that was my only option left. So I had to do surgery, you know.
Not that I believe every doctor's diagnosis, but, you know, what did the doctors tell you, you know, before you had the surgery?
Well, they had an MRI taken, and of course, the MRI showed I had three ruptured discs. And then they told me they'd just do a discectomy, and I should be fine. So, and plus, it'd get me out of pain, so, you know, I was all for it, you know.
You know, I know it's tough sitting around. Wrestling gets in your blood, and when you're an active wrestler, it's a different lifestyle. And, of course, now you're in a lot of pain. It's how are you dealing with everyday life? You know, what are you doing day to day here?
Well, right now, I can't do nothing for the next 21 days. You know, I'm supposed to just take it easy, try to walk, you know, lay on my back a lot. And after that, I go into an extensive rehab program. And then 8 to 10 weeks after that, I go back to the doctor, and hopefully he'll give me some good news and go from there.
Scott, you know, the big question I've got to ask you on the mind of everybody is, you know, what's in the future for Big Papa Pump? Is Scott Steiner going to come back?
Well, I pray to God I can, you know, but, you know, I'll be honest with you, I don't feel great right now. I just can only go by the doctor's prognosis, and he says, you know, with the fragments he took out, he had to cut in half to get out of my body, so it was pretty severe, so I can only go by what the doctor says, and I just, you know, cross my fingers, hope that he's right, you know.